Hey everyone, my name is Dimitri and I'm a Notion fanboy, but sometimes apps come along that are Notion competitors. I've talked about this app before. Xtiles, big fan. But today I wanted to pit it up against Notion and the hit my mic. Treat these things good. I wanted to pit it up against Notion because oftentimes Notion is talked about as this esoteric, almost godlike application that has note-taking capabilities and brainstorming capabilities that are unmatched. But what people don't know, but there are other things out there that can help you get your ideas into a place for you to visualize and then take action on it outside of just Notion. As you can see, Xtiles is actually live on Product Hunt. So if you could go and check them out right now on there, they'd really appreciate it. That's what I would appreciate it. And doesn't that matter? Just a little, maybe. Some really cool things on the product roadmap for Xtiles are actually the fact that they are going to add calendars and tasks, two-sided backlinks, and nesting blocks. Now, this is something that uniquely makes it similar to Notion moving forward. But for now, let's dive into what it can do for you. When you open up Xtiles just like this, you have the option to view your different documents between a grid and a board view. And then you can kind of dive into the software itself. You can also check out what's been shared with you before and what you've worked on recently. And you can create example workspaces here. So I'm going to make one called Rise Productive. I lost the ability to type just now. And then within this, you'll see that it's separate from those documents. So I'm gonna make a document here. And there are a bunch of different templates that you can choose from regarding the different layouts of it. But let's just go with a blank one to start. What I wanna do here is make a content calendar situation. If we go here, you can see that if I drag this, it's essentially a grid that can make different things. But what I'm gonna do is make a layout that makes sense for me. So over here, I'm gonna have overall ideas. I'm gonna have tests for today. I'm actually swap those two. As you can see, you can move things around really easily in these. You can choose to move the blocks or the overall thing itself, like grabbing the top and moving it. And then I'm going to make a section here called quick capture. So what's cool here is that you actually have the similar markdown functionality that Notion does. So if I put slash, you'll see that there's a bunch of different options. I'm gonna put a checkbox. And then this could be record videos. This could be edit videos. And then respond to emails. What I'm gonna do here is show you how you can actually nest things within other ones like this. So if I make a bullet list here, I'm gonna do YouTube, podcast, and newsletter. So if I click on the six dots here, what I can do is I can create subpage. So I do that, and then I could easily have one of these be chosen for now. I'm gonna basically take this grid and use it as example sections. So like I can put Notion videos, and then over here I could put productivity apps, and there's obviously other things I do. So productivity tips. And then an example that I'm gonna be working with soon is automation, Excel videos. So then I can just go back and forth between these two pages by clicking here. And then something really cool to note is that actually if I wanted to, I can make new tabs for this. So here's an example tab. So you can just scroll through these different ones right here and then add another one like this. But say I did the exact same thing, and just to make it easy, I'm gonna make a podcast page out of this one and then make the podcast page and duplicate it. You can either do that or you can press Control D just like with Notion and turn it into a newsletter one. And then you can delete these out by pressing delete. And as you can see, what's really nice in this is that you can actually hide stuff that's under. So you don't need to make the block bigger in order for it to have information within it. So if I, for example, were to make a section like blog, which frankly I don't keep up with anymore, what I could do is I could actually make it this size. And then if I wanted to see it again, I could press more. And the same goes for the to-do list for the day. And this is just a quick capture section. So we can put this here. And then what I want to do is show you how you can actually make this into sort of a Kanban board view. So I have multiple steps within my process. So let's make a couple of these guys right here. So I'm going to take this, use this as an example, call this one research/outline, and then I can duplicate this and I'll put one right next to it. And then I'm going to do writing, then creating, and then editing. Now I'm going to probably tighten these guys up. So now I know this, I'm going to redo this work. So then I'm just going to delete these really quickly and do it again now that I got the sizing right. So I can do that, or I can click on it, press Control D a couple times, and that'll give you more of an idea of my process. So I'm going to resize each of these by a bit, just move them to the end here. So then I'm going to do this and go to creating, editing, rendered, and then live. The cool thing about this, if you have any sort of color coordination here, I do, I'm going to put a different color here. So I'm going to make this guy gray like this. Green, orange, pink, purple, whatever that is. I'm pretty colorblind. And then red. So then what happens is if I, for example, had a video idea here. So let's go back to this grid to show you. I would like to make a video on Xtiles. What I can do here is I can just control X this guy and cut this. So you see that it grabbed everything. Go back to the content calendar and then do this. Obviously, I already did the research and outlining. I can do the creating. And I'm currently in this process now, but there are other videos going on. Like, for example, video that came out a few days ago, stop doing this in Notion. Then I can drag it across the way. But what's very unique is obviously during this brainstorming idea section, there's gonna be different things here that you're gonna work with, different ideas. What if I, at the beginning of this, had made it a sub page? So this is where things start to get really interesting. So this could be a page where I pretty much outline anything. Now, obviously I can outline things like the script. So for example, the script idea that I had here, and due to the really cool feature that is banners. So if I do slash banner, you'll see that there are a couple different options here. This is essentially giving you the ability to segment things more like this. So I had a different title or transition for a bunch of different sections of the video. So this is how I could separate it. And then I could put things like helpful links over here. And when we're making these things, it's always nice that it gives you example things like tables to work with, which with more advanced tables coming in the future, obviously can be used as well for things like content ideas. Something to point out as well is that this tile style can be picked between the overall color or just the top section here. And you can always open the tile itself and write into it as if it was a page. Now this makes it pretty similar to what like Notion looks like in general. And I'm a big fan of this. But what's also cool is the fact that you can take this and hide the title. If for some reason you want to do that, that's the option for it. And any of these can be moved to different panels. So you'll see here, there's this grid 2x2. So say for example, this brainstorming idea is needed to move. I could take this and move it to grid 2x2. You'll see it's right over here. Now I could always move it back to content calendar, and then it would slot right in. And then when it comes to tangibly checking things off your to-do list, they're going to be moving forward with tasks in the future and calendars. So all I'm going to say here is that yes, you can check things off and it's very basic, but for a lot of people, this is how they want to do their to-do list for the day. At the beginning of the day, they're just going to go here and do /2 and check and go through things like this. And to be honest, this is exactly what I do in Notion, just without like date and properties assigned to it. It's like, for example, I usually just have a page and then write sub bullets within that as well. So for example, if we go back to Xtiles, it's very similar to something like this. So say I did this example task, you could always just do sub task like this. And then if I made it a sub page for whatever reason, it could then sort of become a project and I could really dive into the different ideas that I needed to do there. So this could be an example project that you then had multiple visualizations of things within. This is even a crazy more fleshed out idea and process where you could take the different things that make up something like a blog post and connect them all together. So as you can see here, these are helpful links to what you looked into. This is something from Second Brain. These are some notes that you took. And this is the different sections that maybe you could have within the article. And then this breaks down more of what the structure of the actual article is. And you can see the ability to just have a nice visualization while working through a project is really nice. You can have the document itself be the project. You can have subpages within it be projects. You can make it all your own. And it's all because this is based on a grid system that is very easy to work with. Then in the end, you can spit out the final article, or like I had, the final script, and then do the actual work on the platform. And to sum a lot of this up, I think a reason that Xtiles can be a Notion competitor is because it's so visually simple. A lot of people get overwhelmed with all the databases and structural components of things like Notion. But Xtiles is just tiles and pages and stuff. People can get down with nice working functional pages and tiles. I can get down with Notion, but I could also, I can get down with this. But for all those creatives out there, this might be your better option, especially to organize all your different ideas into one workspace. Notion's great for visualizations. Xtiles is great for visualizations. I want to thank Xtiles for sponsoring this video, and I want you to check out this video on how to improve your productivity even more.